It would be nice if Greek always played by the rules, the grammar rules. And usually it does, but at times you'll be looking at a sentence and you go, I just don't think this is proper Greek. Well, usually narrative is a little more straightforward, but especially in Paul, what you often get are real condensed expressions, and he's not breaking Greek grammar. He knows Greek grammar, but it's so compressed and so condensed, it might look like Paul doesn't know Greek. Romans 6:10 is one of those passages. He writes that, knowing that Christ has been raised from the dead, he dies no longer. He'll never die again. And then his expression, death of him no longer rules over. And you may look at this initially and think that autu is a possessive, his death no longer something. But if you look at this verb, you can see that it says of the person with the genitive. So this is death no longer rules over him. And then you get down to verse 10. And this is where this problem is with this neuter pronoun, for which he died. Well, we learned in the rules that the gender of the pronoun is determined by its antecedent. Where is something that's neuter? Well, there isn't anything, is there? You've got masculine, masculine, masculine. So where does this hook into? Well, sometimes when a relative pronoun is referring back to a concept expressed, it goes into the neuter and there's no clear antecedent. But what this verse says to finish it out, for he died which, to death he died once for all, but which he lives to God. Now, obviously you can't go word for word, but I want to focus on this one. What is this? If you go over to Moo's excellent commentary on Romans, footnote 442, he says that Paul writes in a compact style, because this is what I was getting at earlier. Paul will often compress things. We know the relative pronoun is acting as the direct object of apethanon, but look what he goes on to say. Thus we take Paul's ha apethanon to stand for tain thanaton han apethanon. So what that means is that you can replace the ha with the death which he died. So that's clearly what he's referring to. But instead of writing out the full expression, he just says ha, and the neuter signals he's going back not so much to a specific word, but to a concept. And when you notice when you get down here, you have the same kind of construction. And Moo comments, Paul uses the same construction with a relative pronoun, just like he did at the beginning of the verse. So obviously you can't go word for word. You have to fill in what the death which he died. And that's why I said for the death he died. And most translations do that kind of thing. And then, but the life which he lives, okay, but which he lives to God. So Paul is just using a very compact style, and it may confuse first-year Greek students or even second-year Greek students. That's why we need commentaries and people like Moo and Schreiner to write their really excellent commentaries. And you sometimes have to check that to see what's going on. By the way, if you're not familiar with Moo's idiom book, it is a masterful book. It's not a complete grammar, but he deals with very specific kinds of constructions. It's a really helpful book to have. I don't even know if it's still in print, but you should have one. If you are wanting to do second year and beyond Greek studies.